Okay, so here we are on the Oscar AOP-5, and what we're going to be doing is just having a look at some landings. So I'm teaching a friend of mine to fly this Oscar, so we're going to look at some three-point landings, and then we'll take a look at some wheeler landings. Now, people say that you can't wheel an Oscar, but you can wheel an Oscar, and I'll show you how. So that should be fun. Okay, so taxing the Oscar. I've got the stick mic back, and I'm just weaving, you know, as you do in any tail dragger. Okay, so weaving to the right, looking to the left, and full left rudder, and looking to the right. Okay, now all this is made difficult when there's a crosswind. The crosswind tends to want to weather cock this kite very easily. So, for example, if I had a crosswind now coming from the left, the aircraft would just want to go to the left all the time, and I'd have full right rudder in and a bit of right brake trying to keep it going straight, but sometimes that's not enough. So, you got full right rudder, a bit of right brake, and you have to give it a little blast of power just to get the tail round. As my friend found out the other day in quite a strong crosswind. Okay, so we'll just take a look at the actual manoeuvring the Oscar round. So there's not a lot of wind at the moment. If I want to go right, full right rudder, and then a bit of heel brake, and if I progressively taxi, it does go round, but if I give it a blast of power, it does swing round quite nicely, and of course the door opens. Classic Oscar. It shouldn't secure. Okay, so let's do that again. So I want to go right, full right rudder, bit of brake, and a blast of power, and there you go. It wants to go round like so. I found that technique a lot easier than just a little trickle of power with full rudder and a bit of brake. I find that extra blast gets me round. Okay, apply the brakes, which don't really apply. And there we go. Throttle friction, trimmer, mixture, mags are on, fuel is on the main tank, flaps, one stage of flaps. Okay. If I try and do a mag check, we're just going to go forward, so I can't get more than, there you go, 1200 RPM, terrible. I can do the mag check there. Give that chance to kick in. Close the window. Little Grandstand Radio, Golf Alpha India, QECO, lining up 10. Okay, checking the approach, no transponder. Don't need a P2, don't need lights, just making sure it's all clear. Checking the windsock, as we always do. Wind's coming from the left. So, correct technique, here we go. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the stick all the way forward. You can have it all the way back, it doesn't matter. On Oscars, I go all the way forward. Wind's coming from the left, so a little bit of left stick. Okay, I'm just going to gradually increase the power. Okay, so the tail is up immediately. I'm just easing the stick back now, getting a nice shallow climb attitude. I'm at 40 miles an hour, 50 miles an hour. It's easy going to take off now, and there we go. Starts to rise, stick forward, climbing away, positive rate of climb. And I'm going to go for 60 miles an hour, which is quite a steep angle, actually. There you go, 60 miles an hour nailed. I'm not going to put the flaps up until we get to about 500 feet, just in case the donkey decides to quit. Little bit of turbulence and a right turn into the circuit. Okay, we're roughly 500 feet there, flaps away. And locked. Back on the downwind leg, 70 miles an hour, and there we have it. And I'm going to put one stage of flap down there as we go around the corner, just below 70. That's nice. Okay, I'm going to make the field there, so full flap going in now, make the right corrections, and Kilo Echo turning final 1-0. Okay, so I've got the speed nailed at 60 miles an hour. I'm going to put the camera forward for the next one, so we'll be able to see what I'm doing. But just so you can see me on this one, and then you'll see my perspective on the next one. And keep like I copied that. Have a good day. Okay, so prop fully forward. We have got one on here. Undercarriage. I will say that just in case. And flaps fully down. Nailed the speed at 60 miles an hour. Some expert Oster owners would probably be about 45 miles an hour here, but like I say, this is me with about 60 hours. Okay, so I've nailed the speed at 60. I'm coming around the corner. I've got the runway inside. I'm just going to get the centre line. Now what I'm aiming to do is slingshot myself across the ground, and that's it. And I don't want to land, I just want to fly low level. When I say low level, I mean about 1 foot across the ground. If I feel a sink, I'm going to put the power on. Okay, so 60 on the nose, carpet going in now. 60 on the nose. Okay, I'm aiming at the numbers at 60, okay? And now I'm going to get myself low level, low level, low level. There you go, about 2 feet there. Okay, now I'm literally going across the ground, raising the nose there to the pre-born attitude, and wow, look at that, grease that. I'm putting the flaps up just to kill the lift. That's just my own little technique. And pedalling away, just keeping direction with the pedals. Okay, so, okay, now direct, look at this, VT is going, ooh, yeah, ooh, you dancer. Sticks into wind. And there we go, anticipating every single move until she stops. And a bit of heel break, heel, 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 we're running at the same time. There you go, keeping it straight. There we go. That's my opinion on it, I'm sure. With the pedals. Okay, so happy with that? Okay, let's see it facing that way.